The skimmer is a separate playhead in the timeline, and it's a separate playhead in the events browser. When you move the skimmer, because that's the active playhead, it's red. When you click on a clip, the fixed playhead jumps to that location, and you can see at this point that it's yellow. But the skimmer is still skimming and active. I would suggest, until you get used to the skimmer, it's a good idea to turn it off when you're in the timeline, though it is very useful in the browser. To turn it off is simply going to this location or pressing the S key, so you can turn it off and on at will. In the same location as where the skimmer is turned on and off, we have the snapping key. Now the snapping key is grey as off and on is blue. What happens here is if you move the playhead to an edit point, it snaps to that location. If snapping is turned off, then it smoothly moves past that location. Snapping can be turned off and on with the N key. Also, up in the area where the skimmer and the snapping buttons are is the audio skimmer. And the audio skimmer is probably best left turned off, though this is a personal thing. If you turn it on, when you scrub through, you can hear the audio in the background so that you can pick up on a particular thing. Perhaps if you're looking for the start of someone making a speech, this would be a useful tool. I hope you've enjoyed this video. Thank you for watching. If you haven't done so, please like, subscribe, and press the bell.